Hi, I'm Misha Dahlia. Welcome to my channel. So, for those who might not know, I recently just published my poetry book, my very, very first book, which is called From Seed to Flower. This book means so much to me, and I think that I've been talking about it all over my social media, so it's actually kind of surprising if you actually don't know that I came up with this book because it's everywhere. I post about it all the time, every day. And I think people are starting to get tired of it, but I won't get tired of posting it because it's my baby and I want everybody to know how proud I am of myself that I managed to come up with this book. So, this poetry book, I managed to finish this book in a span of 2 weeks, 12 days to be exact. And it's really a I wrote it when I was going through some things, and I was in the middle of a class, and I was like, you know what, I can't focus because I have all of this built up emotions that I have in me, and I just need to let it out. So I was like, you know what, I texted my friends. I actually still have the text. I was like, not me writing poems in class, and they were just laughing. And in a span of 20 minutes, I managed to write four poems, if not mistaken. It's the emotions. Like, I just couldn't help it, and I just kept on pouring and pouring whatever I felt at that moment. And now I have it in my hands. It's like, wow. Wow. I'll be talking about what my book is about. From Seed to Flower symbolizes growth. So, seed means you're still a child and you grow up to be a beautiful flower. So that's what it means. And in my book, I have nine different flowers, and each different flowers, I have managed to put 10 petals. So the petals means poems, and each flower is like a chapter. So yeah, so the flowers are jasmine, dahlia, iris, lily, rose. I don't know how you pronounce this. Bougainvillea, I think. Poppy, azalea, and daisy. I didn't just randomly chose the flowers. All of the flowers mean something to me. Like, for example, jasmine is one of my best friend's name and also my mother's name. Dahlia, obviously my name, and Iris, my younger sister's name. And then we have azalea, which is my cousin's name. And then we have bougainvillea, which is my other best friend, Ali's favorite flower. I mean, it's not her favorite flower. She like, when I asked her, like, what's her favorite flower, I want her to feel included in my books. And she was like, I don't have a favorite flower, but I guess bougainvillea would do because it signifies something to her, like a really deep meaning to her. And I was like, hey, you know what, whatever bougainvillea it is. And then we also have rose, lily, daisy, and poppy. So all of these four flowers mean something to me. If you don't know, or if you have never heard of the Addicted and Colorway Sister series, and also A Thousand Boy Kisses. So the Addicted and Colorway Sister series is written by Krista and Becca Ritchie, and the series contains 10 books. I could go on for ages if I were to talk about them, but basically the characters, I mean the Colorway Sisters, there's four of them: Poppy, Rose, Lily, and Daisy. Poppy is irrelevant. But then in A Thousand Boy Kisses, which is another book written by Tilly Cole, the main character's name is Poppy, and Poppy, that book means so much to me. And it kind of, and I was like, oh, you know what, maybe I could, like, put Poppy inside, because the Colorway Sisters series, there's a Poppy, but I'm not talking about that Poppy. I'm talking about another Poppy. But anyways, so I feel really, really, really glad that I managed to put all of these characters and also those who mean so much to me into one book. For some people, oh my god, I just realized that I was holding the book, terbalik. Anyways, it means so much to me. And for people, maybe they were like, oh, maybe she just picked these random flowers because, flowers, they're beautiful and blah blah blah. But no, actually, I chose these flowers specifically because they mean so much to me, and I feel really, I don't know, it's just really overwhelming because what? What? So each different flower has its own meaning. For example, rose, you have love, and then poppy, you have grief, and daisy means new beginnings and stuff like that. So each different flower has its own meanings, and the poems that I wrote under the flowers, it correlates to the meaning. So for example, rose, it means love. All of the poems under the rose flower, it has something to got to do with romance. And then for daisy, which means new beginning, so the poems I wrote under the daisy flower means growth, like you grow up from something, like a bad past or something like that. I digitally published the book on iBooks and Barnes & Noble, so you can get that for $2.99. And I also sell it for 8 ringgit because I just realized people outside from the US, they can't purchase ebooks from iBooks and also Barnes & Noble. So I thought that that was really unfair. So I decided to sell it myself and sell it for 8 ringgit for the ebook or PDF version. I am thinking of publishing it like properly. It's still in the works. I don't know if I'm gonna actually do it, because you know, releasing books in general, it's like you write your emotions, your raw and heartful emotions, and having the public to read it, it gets really overwhelming, because it's like you leave your heart in the open and they can just read your mind and understand what you feel and know what you feel about certain things, and it's really scary. These poems mean so much to me because I learned so much by writing. It's like, so I wrote the poems because I have all of these jumbled up feelings in my head, and I thought that by writing, it managed to untangle each different emotion I have, and it made me understand my emotions clearer. And when I read my poems out loud to myself, I will be like, oh, it makes so much sense why I'm feeling this way. Because oh my gosh, I suck at explaining and describing what I feel. So I feel that by writing is the only way that had managed for me to let my emotions out and let people hear what I think. What I was saying is really scary to have people know what you feel. But so when I first finished the book, I emailed it to some of my closest friends. So I just wanted to know what they feel of it. All of them had given me really good reviews, and one of my friends, Ellie, she cried. She read, I think I said earlier that the bougainvillea flower is about her, is for her, and she read that flower first and she started bawling her eyes out, and she actually recorded herself crying. And I was like, oh my god, because Ellie never cries. Never cries. It's so hard. It's always me and Jasmine. So there's like three of us in a group, me, Jasmine, and Ellie. Me and Jasmine, we cry all the time. Like, I was going through something and I keep on sending them like crying selfies, and they're not even fazed by it anymore, maybe because they're so used to seeing me cry. And Jasmine too, Jasmine cries a lot. Like, Jasmine and me, we're crying buddies. We cry all the time. But Ellie, it's really hard for her to get her to open up and cry. And when she cried, I was like, oh my god, was it really that deep? Oh my god. So I felt like, oh my god, my words really made an impact to her that deep, to the point where she cries. Like, Ellie, she never cries. And she cried reading my poems. I felt like, oh my god, I kind of felt proud that I managed to make her cry. But anyways, I'm getting off topic. Yeah, and I got a lot of good reviews from my friends, and they were like, most of them could relate to what I wrote, which is sad really, because what I wrote is really is from like bad stuff that happened to me, and knowing that they could relate to what I felt, it was sad, but at the same time, it's beautiful. This is the thing that I love about writing. For example, an author, they will write something based on what they feel, and their readers would read the books and was like, oh my god, I could totally relate to what they're saying. And you know, you build a connection just by writing words. It's actually a really beautiful thing if you know, if you get what I'm saying and if you get what I'm seeing in that kind of perspective. Like, you get to connect, you get to bond and relate through your experiences, and the poem is the bridge for you both to feel the same way. Like, Ellie was, you know, when Ellie first read my poem, she said that she could relate it because, and then she said something about her past that happened, and I was like, oh my gosh, I wrote about something that I went through, but I did not know that a lot of people could relate to it, because people, okay, I'm a psychology student, so don't, this might get deep, but it's because a lot of people, I mean, everyone, we try to relate to a thing as much as possible based on your own experiences. So if I write based on my experiences, someone else will look into it based on what they feel and based on what they had been through. So, like I said, again, it's like a bridge. Writing is like a bridge between two people to make you feel connected, to make you have this beautiful bond. And, oh my God, I think I'm getting ahead of myself. But yeah, you get what I mean. The other day, I did a question thingy on Instagram, and, you know, just to, you know, if anyone has any questions about my book, From Seed to Flower. And I had received some questions, so I'm gonna answer them. Okay, here it is. Annie and Aisha, my cousin, they asked, what inspires me to write? I'm inspired mostly based on my own experiences, and if I feel like I just couldn't keep it anymore, I would write about it. Then before I know it, it's already night and I need to catch up on Grey's Anatomy. After I'm okay, I will look back at the poem and would modify it and like change some things, and yeah. So yeah, my experiences, that's what I would say. Like, that's what inspires me to write. So the next question is, how did you write it all within a short period of time? I was going through some things. It was a bad time for me. And I remember crying and writing. And then before you know it, I'm done. Like, I've managed to, like, I remember the 8th day of writing, I remember I wrote 25 over poems in one day. All of my friends were like, how did you do it? I honestly don't know what to answer, because I myself don't know how I managed to write a lot of poetry in a span of one day. And I got like, am I supposed to, you know, not write too many poems in one day? I don't know. But then again, it depends on the person and how they manage to write. So yeah, it's the emotions. So I guess that's what made me able to write this book in 12 days. And then we have, was it hard to write some of the poems that are more to your personal life? Yes, it was. There's this one specific poem, Under the Rose Flower, that I was actually really scared. I actually was contemplating whether I should or should not have it published, or, you know, because it feels so very personal to me. But then I consulted to one of my best friends, Amelia. She said it's, and I quote, she said, that's so good, it's so powerful, I literally got goosebumps, it's amazing, put it in there, it's so good, wow, I'm so proud of you. And but wait, it's literally so good, personal and relatable. And I told her that I was scared of how people would react, and she said, it's a prize for the craft, and I stand by that. Yes, it was very, very hard to write something really personal to me, because I feel that if I were to put out something really personal about myself, people would know me more than what I intend for them to know about me. Hard because it's hard for me to have it published. Easy because I could relate to it, because it's what happened to me, so I could easily write it because I felt it. But it's hard in that sense where I should or should not have people read my work. if that makes sense. I hope that makes sense. So it's hard, but it's easy at the same time. Easy to write, hard to share. Next question. Talk about how you suddenly couldn't open your Goodbye Grayson Word document. So if you know me, I am currently writing a novel. I've been writing this book since I was 16. I'm turning 19 this year. I wrote this book since I was 16 and it's still not done yet. I mean, it's almost done, I guess. It's my very first book. It's the first book that I wrote, but this is the first book that I've published. So I have like 2 books in total. And the other day I got a scare because I restarted my computer, I think. And then I suddenly couldn't open my novel's document. I started bawling my eyes out because I have put like so much work into the book, because it took me ages to get that far. And having it when the notification popped up and said, oh, you know, this file couldn't be recovered and stuff like that, I was like, oh my god, what is happening? So I started crying. But then I remembered, before I restarted my computer, I sent all of the documents and files that I have in my computer, I emailed it to myself. So imagine how relieved I was when I was able to get the Word document back. And I was like, oh my gosh, I have never been so relieved before having to manage to open it. So yeah, that's that. Next question. Besides poetry, are you interested in publishing books that are from different genres? Yes. Goodbye Grayson. Goodbye Grayson is a murder mystery, romance kind of thing. And yeah, so that's fun. So the next question is, when will Goodbye Grayson launch? I don't know. I am probably about 75% done with it. So here's the thing about me and writing. I write and I could go on for days. And then when I stop for months. I would get in such a big slump to the point where I would just not open the document for months and would just leave it be. And then when I suddenly feel motivated again, I would write for days. And then I stop for months. So it goes like in a cycle. It's just that it's a habit of mine. I tend to procrastinate and end up doing something else instead of focusing on my writing. So the next one, it's by Amelia, one of my best friends earlier. Which is your favorite petal or flower that you've written? I would say one of my favorites would be under the jasmine petal. So give me a sec, I'm gonna look for it. Okay, I'm gonna read this. It's under petal 5. I am a mere seed, seeking for sunlight to bloom. You are my sun, but why the silent gloom? I wilt when you sob, I bend as you scream. For I am a mere seed, with only hopes and dreams. Please do not shout, please do not scream. I try to bloom by myself, but I need you in order to succeed. Stay with me, be by my side. Let's be together forever, because I need you and you need I. So that is one of my favorite poems from under the jasmine flower, because so basically the jasmine flower symbolizes the young. So it's I wrote it based from what my experience is as a daughter and as a sister, basically as who I am right now. And it's like I wrote it because it means that children, we depend on our parents to grow. So sunlight symbolizes parents, and I am a mere seed means the young, means their children. We constantly look up to our parents, and if we see our parents sad or angry, we tend to ask why are they feeling like this. And usually parents, when I was younger, parents don't usually open up to you because you're a child and they expect you not to know or understand how they're feeling. But that's the point. As children, we are constantly curious and we want to know. But if parents aren't there to let you know what they're feeling, how are we supposed to understand? So yeah, everything just goes back to my own personal experience. Next is from Steph. She is amazing. I met her also has a YouTube channel. I leave the link, I think, in the description box, so you guys can be sure to check her out. She talks about books. She's as passionate about the Addicted and Colorblind Sister series as I am, so be sure to check her account out. She's amazing. I love her so much. She asked, how did you find time to write and stay motivated to keep writing? Honestly, maybe it's just me, because every time if I start something, I won't be able to put it down. Like, I need to get it finished. But then if I stop writing for like a day, I would find myself in a slump for months. Maybe that's just me. I mean, it all depends on how you are like as a writer, I guess. Or because different people, we have different writing abilities. Some might underestimate writers and be like, oh, you just write, you just sit down and just write. But they don't know how hard it is to be able to make a sentence out of your everything that's going on in your head. So, for example, you'll have like a scenario that's happening in your head and you want to put it down in a novel. It's hard having to describe what's happening in your head because you need to make sure every little detail is perfect and is as what you imagined in your head. So that's really important and it's hard. See, I got off topic again. Anyways, back to her question. How do you find time to write? I wrote during class. Don't do what I did. I, throughout the 12 days that I wrote this book, I mostly write it during class. I will end up watching the recording again late at night because I find it easier to study and absorb information at night rather than in the day. So that's just me. But yeah, I write during class and then I just write. Don't do what I did. I would not recommend it to anyone and I regret doing it. But then again, I kind of not. But I mean, it's hard having to get back on my feet. But you know what they say, hustle do me hustle, I guess. We have the last question. Favorite parts of your books? Favorite part. So I said my favorite poem just now, which was Petal 5 Under Jasmine. My favorite part of my book, I would say Under the Poppy Flower. Under the Poppy Flower is grief. And I wrote so many heart-wrenching stuff, to be honest, because Poppy Under Grief, I talked about how I lost my baby sister when I was 13, and it was a really hard thing to talk about and to open up about it. See, I can't talk about it because I'll end up crying. Eve Flower, I talked about so many people that I have lost over the years, and not only my baby sister but also my grandfather on my mother's side. I was close with him, and then yeah, he passed away. And then my baby sister, I didn't get to meet her at all because my mom had a miscarriage. All of us were not expecting her to get pregnant because she just said, okay, that's it, 3 is enough. But then she got pregnant, and I don't know if they were planning to have that pregnancy, but I don't think so. You know, it sucks because I watch reality TV shows and I was like, oh my god, why are they crying in front of the camera? But then it's really hard because it's like you're talking to yourself and all of these emotions that you have never let go before, and it's like And then yeah, she had to get the procedure done, and after that we buried my baby sibling, and it was traumatizing. It's actually, I haven't spoken to anyone about this in ever, actually. So that's why I wrote my feelings in my book, so that's how I let people know that I'm still hurting. I just don't want to feel alone. That's why I wrote what I wrote, you know, just to feel some sort of release, to know that she and my grandfather are happier there. So enough of the sad part. So one of the flowers in my book is called Bougainvillea, which means passion. I wrote this because it related to Ellie, my best friend, and I also wrote this because of all of the friendships that I had made over the past year, almost 2 years of being friends with so many amazing people through the book community. So I am gonna FaceTime one of my best friends, online best friends, Marin. Hi! Oh my god, you did your hair! That was so great! You look pretty as ever. Yes, so I'm gonna show you off to my camera. So this is Marin.
Hello!
Introduce yourself.
So my name is Marin, as she said. I am living in Scandinavia and I'm studying literature and I've known Misha for almost a year now.
Oh my god, that's so crazy!
It's insane!
Right?
It feels like it's been like 3 months or something.
Yeah, and it's been a year. Like, it's just, I don't know, it feels so surreal. And now that we've come a long way.
Yeah, and it's not just one book.
Right! Right!
It's so many books.
Yeah. And it's just, oh my god, 1 year is a really long time. It's not like...
It is.
Yeah.
We went from like discussing after in just random group chats to now having like a published freaking author in our friend group.
That's insane. Yeah, Marin is also one of the first to receive my book. She did her hair because of this. I literally told her this like what, 15 minutes ago?
That's how much I love you and this book. Like, I did my hair for you. No, but I like From Seed to Flower, it's a beautifully written book, so like everyone has to read it. It's not just like you should read it, you have to read it. It's something everyone can relate to, because the poems and the petals and flowers, they're also diverse, and there's always something you can relate to depending on your circumstance, your situation, whether you live in Scandinavia or Malaysia or something to get out of it.
Right.
And
right.
It's not just because it's a good book. It's also because, like, you wrote it. But I do not enjoy it because you wrote it. I enjoyed it because it's a good book.
Right. Is this so... Oh, my gosh.
It's just so surreal to think about the fact that you've written a book.
Yeah.
And the book is good. Like, what?
Yeah, but it's, like, so... I feel really... scared to have people read it. I think I told you about it, because I felt like, you know, having writing every single emotion you have and you write it down in a book and having people read your work is like, it's like they're in your head and they know how you feel, which is scary.
You're really putting yourself out there.
Yeah, and it's like I'm digging my own grave, but then I'm not regretting it, so...
But at the same time, you're, like, allowing other girls that might have these feelings, and boys, of course, that have these feelings inside of them. Like, I'm not alone. It's good to know that I'm not alone. And since you were able to put yourself out there and express so much vulnerability, you're just inspiring so many others to do the same.
Aww.
And, like, I don't have to tell my feelings through words anymore, G. I can just send you a petal and we're good.
I feel like it's because we have so many things in common, especially because how the world see us. You know, if we were to read a book, I think I have this written in one of the flowers. Like, if people were to see us holding a book, they'll be like, oh my god, you're such a nerd. And stuff
so
like that.
True.
But little do they know.
It's the same stigma, and it's just like, this sounds weird to say, but books are cool. Like,
yeah, books are cool. Say what you want to say.
Yeah, they
books are.
Cool.
So thank you, Marin.
Thank you for having me.
I'm gonna leave your Bookstagram link on the thing, if it's okay. That'll be cool. She lives literally in a fairyland. I am not kidding. She goes on walks in like forest and it's filled with snow and her pictures are so aesthetic.
It's because Twilight Core.
It's so beautiful, and I told her this a lot of times. I told her that I'm gonna move in with her and her boyfriend. I am not kidding. I will.
I have the bed ready.
Sorry?
I have the bed ready. I'm just telling me when I'll put out a towel.
Yes.
And, like,
I'm gonna move in with Marin. Like, any, like, just you wait. Like, I will.
Yeah.
Okay, so thank you, Marin. I'll snap you soon. Thank you. I love you.
Mwah.
Bye-bye. Bye. I hope she answers. She usually answers. Hi. Are you okay?
Oi.
Are you okay?
Yeah, why?
Why are you crying?
I'm not crying. What are you talking about?
You, no, because like, I don't know, maybe it was my phone because nampak like a tear just fell from your eye.
I just ate KFC, bro.
I thought you said you ordered McDonald's.
I did both.
Okay, anyway, so I'm filming right now. So you're on camera. Wait, I don't know if you can see, but I think so. Wait, my camera.
Hi.
But so I was talking about the bougainvillea flower because I'm talking about my book. So I cheated about how you cried when you read the poem.
Oh yeah. To the camera, I did cry while reading Misha's poems. Especially the last, I think it was Lily.
Was it Lily?
I don't know. But it was like the last few chapters. Because I only managed to read, I mean the first time I read it, I only managed to read Bougainvillea, which is mine. Mm-hmm. And Bougainvillea onwards. And I just remember like started tearing up because I know how Misha is like, and like her, I just know who Misha is, so reading it felt so personal, and yeah, I just shed a few tears.
Yeah, and it's so hard to get Ellie to cry, that's why I was like, oh my god, she cried. Okay girl, talk to you soon.
Bye.
So that's Ellie. Let me call Jasmine. She's scared. She doesn't trust me. She doesn't trust me at any about FaceTime. So I'm filming right now. And I'm talking about my book.
Mm-hmm.
And I was talking about Ellie's chapter, Bougainvillea, and how she cried reading it.
Mm-hmm.
So, and you know how the jasmine flower is for you?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. I'm gonna show you off to the camera, so better take the headband off. She's running. She's running to her room.
Can you like give me some time?
So this is my camera, say hi.
Hi.
She's not gonna show her face, but then yeah, so Jasmine's one of the
chapters.
One of the chapters, and she's also one of the first ones who read the digital copy of my book.
Okay, so I think more than the content, what makes me really happy about this book was that Misha finally took her step. It was so random, out of the blue, but I bet the fact that she has released her book has always been the back of her mind, and the fact that she already did it, I'm just so proud, you know, like, bitch, I'm a mother, you know, so like, so proud of her, and also, especially because knowing that a chapter was dedicated to me just makes it even more special for me, so I read it, and it just made me understand her a lot more, although we literally talk on a daily basis, but...
Every day, no fail.
Yeah, but yeah.
Yeah,
a great book, and I can't talk too much about it because no spoilers. But please remember to go buy it on where?
iBooks and Goodreads. iBooks and Barnes and Nobles.
Yes, and yeah. Because yeah. I just love her and her book. So get the soft and the hard copy.
Thanks, Bull. I'll call you later.
Bye.
Well, I think that's all for today's video. This is actually a really lengthy video because so many things happened. I went from talking about my book to answering Q&As and to calling my friends. So thank you so much if you're still here at the end of the video, because I understand you guys probably have so many things to do than watch this video. But so yes, before I end, I just want to say thank you so much to those who have bought my book and to those who have been encouraging me and saying so many lovely things about my book. I am so glad that you loved it. It's not the most perfect or amazing poetry book because I'm still getting used to the whole poetry kind of thing, you know, kind of vibe. All of the emotions that I put into writing this book are all real. It's all from me. It's all what I felt all of these years, and it's just so good having to put all of the emotions in one book. I mean, I'm really glad that I managed to relate it to every aspect of my life. be it from friendship to family to love to heartbreak and to grieving and stuff like that. I'm just so glad that I managed to put all of that in one book, and it feels scary having to put it out in the world for people to read and judge my writing, but then again, it's my work, and if I feel happy and proud about it, then that's all that matters. You have to love what you do, and if people were to bring you down and say that, oh my god, you did a really bad job at this and that, if they're judging you for doing something that you love wrong, they're horrible people. Everybody now is like so judgmental, and they can't handle knowing the fact that you're able to do things that they can't. People are always going to be envious of you. They're always going to try to bring you down. But know that your happiness is all that matters. And if you're happy, the only way I can say this is to curse, but I can't curse. So just ignore what people say and just do what makes you happy, because that's all that's important. It's your life. I suck at giving what's it called? Advices. So read my book to find out what I'm trying to say, because I suck at saying things. I write it down, everything inside my book. So From Seed to Flower, you can get it on iBooks or Barnes & Noble's online digital stores for only $2.99. And if you aren't able to buy it from there, you can DM me or text me if you have my number. Yeah. Let me know if you want to buy it, and I'll lead you through the whole process of it. So yeah, so once again, thank you so much for watching and tuning in, and I hope that you guys are able to read this book one day, or if you have, thank you so much, and let me know what you think if you read it. You can DM me anytime, mention me in your story, or like tag me on Instagram or Twitter, and I'll of course reply to you guys. Thank you, and I'll see you guys next time.